ก็เดี๋ยวเนี่ยน่าจะ
do another install and uninstall video, I guess. I'm getting a bit bored now with this noise again. I just can't stand the induction noise sometimes. Yeah. And I also notice that power drops because it just sucks in loads of heat. You know, got the gold going on, the heat away. I still notice a bit of power. Just don't feel it as respond as good as the standard airbox. So anyway, I'm going to show you how to remove all this crap and put your standard airbox back in. It's also the same as removing your standard airbox. So let me go and get my standard box quickly. So this is the standard airbox. As you know, it's a big old heavy beastie thing. And that's where the ECU would sit in there. And that's where the air would go in. The best thing I found to do when you remove this and reinstall it is to remove this part, this section down here, which I will do. I think it just pulls off. Yeah, it just pulls out, so remove that and then it should be a little bit easier to install. It's a flathead screwdriver because I'm going to need to take off that blue induction pipe and my custom ECU bracket. I'm going to have to remove that. Yeah, so get a flathead screwdriver on that. Cool, right, I hope you guys can see alright. I think that's the right height. Now I can higher up a bit more. A bit about there. Alright, it's easy to do. Fuck's sake, hitting that frickin'. It's cause my camera stand has these massive legs on it and I keep bloody kicking them. So, just move my custom ECU bracket, it's easy. I've undone the clip already, so that just moves. So just remove your Group A air filter pipe. I'm only removing it because, like I said, I don't like the noise very often. It's okay every now and then, but it gets a bit annoying and gets a bit too intrusive in a while. And also, because you can hear it, you feel like you've got to drive like an absolute moron on the roads just to experience the sound. So I'm just removing it and putting my standard airbox back on because at the moment I keep driving like an idiot. And I don't like driving like that because I'm not really that sort of person. Anyway, I'm not really that sort of person. Anyway, yeah. So that's as easy as 1, 2, 3, really. Just give it a good tug. I'll tell you what, anyone out there want to buy this off me? Let me know in the comment section because then it gives me an excuse not to, you know, use it anymore, or gives me an excuse just to keep my standard air filter back on. So anyone out there want to buy this Group A air filter, let me know. So yeah, after you remove that, I've now got to remove my custom ECU bracket. I'm not going to show you how I've done that because it is the most pikey-ish sort of way I've made it. So I'm just going to pause it here, take off all the tape that I've put on there and the bracket that I've made. Yeah, it's just not worth showing because you would just be like, why didn't you just buy yourself an RS ECU holder? Well, I have got one coming, but it's not arrived yet. I thought it would have arrived. So, like I said, just want to put my standard airbox back on. But if you're taking your standard airbox off to put Group A on, you will need to take off the crossover pipe and the silicone bit here. You need to remove that. You need to remove your airflow mass sensor as well. Just remember what position it's in. Okay, so I think it's at the 2 or 3 o'clock position. Okay, I've been reading that it does make an effect on the car, how it drives, depending on what position that is in. All right, but for me, because I have a silicone joiner on there and it's in the position already where my standard airbox will slot straight into there, I don't need to touch any of that. But if you've got all standard, you will need to remove all that, okay? So yeah, you need to remove it from that section all the way along. There's two pipes behind the crossover pipe. There's a little push and squeeze tab on this side, pull that off, and there's a little rubber silicone hose you just push off as well, and that's how you remove that top crossover pipe. So that's how you remove that. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna remove that now. I'll put a little bit of a better angle. So yeah, after you remove your ECU bracket, people struggle now because the ECU wiring and the casing is, it's a pain in the ass, all right, because it's just very short, the wiring's short and it's very tight, and the bracket that holds the ECU in has a Torx piece, a screw, it goes right through the middle of it. Now sometimes they do not come out, mine does not come out, I've tried taking it off, but you need to go and hacksaw the shit out of that, or you know, chop it off somehow to remove your ECU actual cover. Damn this bloody bracket of mine. So yeah, but for me, I've made a little bit more room down here. I've done some wire tucking quite a while ago down here. I've done some wire tucking like for the battery, and now I've tucked most of the wires as far back as I can out of the way, so now I've got enough space down here to get that ECU. I also cut some of the tape that was off the ECU and sort of spread the wires out and then retaped it up. All right, and then now the ECU moves around a little bit easier, and like I said, I've made enough space so then I can actually pick my ECU up and tuck it down out the way so that I can slide my airbox back in. So I will try and show you as best I can. I'll try and move this bracket up again. I'll try and tilt the camera so you can sort of see. Best thing I can do is pick up the bloody camera. Alright, okay. So yeah, as you can see, some of the wires are tucked. I twisted it and pushed them out of the way. Most of the wires I've actually tucked out of the way. So now I've got a nice big gap here. Okay. The only problem is you might find your water hose in the way. But again, you should be okay if you just do what I do, pick it up and put it out of the way a little bit. Or even cable tie it to that, just so you get enough room. Alright, so this is the fiddly part. I don't know if I'll be able to do it with one hand. As you can see, my ECU, I've cut some of the tape off, as I said, so I've spread out some of the wiring. Doesn't affect the ECU. You will need to pull up on the water hose just enough, and then you can tuck your ECU down the wiring part in between this gap here. Give it a go. I'm going to try and put the camera down somewhere. I'm gonna gaffer tape my camera down, stop it, get out of this angle. Alright, so like I said, I've got a little bit, ouch, sharp down there, so careful. I hope you guys can see, but yeah. Now I've got my ECU, what I've got to do is twist it. Like I said, the wiring is now down out of the way. Alright, it's a bit tight, but it will go down. Alright, just keep fiddling with it, it will go down. Enough, there we go. So now the ECU's got enough space out the way. See, it sits just there nicely. Might be able to push down a little bit more on it. Alright, so now it's quite tucked out the way for now, and then I can get my standard air filter back on there. 2 seconds. Right, now the fiddly part. Now there is a way you can do this. Alright, so you have to try and get your ECU and air filter in a right position to do this. I'm going to try and move this out of the way. I'm sorry if I can't get very good detail and camera angle on it. But yeah, you need to get it in an upright position almost. Care for your cooling pipes. Right, and then sort of as you saw then, it's gone at an angle. So yeah, as you can see, it's gone a bit more at an angle. There's these bloody arm leg things here, they're a pain in the ass, alright? So now, I'll try you again actually. Gone at 12 o'clock position. There's another arm just down there, you can sort of see it. That arm there, you need to get that tucked under there. So as you get it down, then you can sort of angle it like this, and then sort of at 5 o'clock position or 3, depending on what way you're looking at it. So now it's halfway in. Okay, so now you've got it like that. I just got to wrestle it in there already. As I did there, there's a little lump here that sort of sticks up to get where the air filter sits. You have to try and get it past the top of the radiator fan. So you've done that, you can sort of wrestle it in. Again, be careful your pipe, you've got a pipe working there. You sort of disconnect your pipes. You sort of pull it up out of the way a little bit. It will go. As I said, when you remove that bit on the air filter on that side, that sort of pipe that sticks up, you can get your hand in there and you just sort of help it along as well. Okay, so now it's almost in. Right, it's very fiddly when you've got it halfway, okay? Best thing I'm around to do as well, sorry about the camera angles today, is to remove the pipe that goes over. So remove that and you've got enough room here for it to wriggle around a bit more. And after that you can pull your ECU up, make sure this bit's sticking up a bit, you can pull your ECU up and sort of sit it just here, sort of at an angle, and you can sort of like foddle this into its position. It's rubber grommet area. So yeah, I'm going to try and do that now quickly. It is very fiddly, it's the worst freaking design ever.
Yeah, it's a pain in the ass. Just gotta keep fiddling with it.
When I first done it, I was like, Jesus Christ, how did they get this in there? Oh, how the hell did you get this out of here? You know? We'll go in. So now you have wriggle room to get that into its position. Alright, just keep wriggling at it and it will slot into its position in the standard air box. Right, okay, so after you've done that, you can remove your ECU from there and tuck it in over here for now. A bit fiddly, but it will go into its position. Alright, after that, I did have to undo that bolt over there, that jubilee clip, so now I can wriggle this around and get it into its position. Make sure it's in, but there's a bit of a gap, but don't worry about that, as soon as you start doing it up, it will close itself in. So yeah, you're going to need your little Torx bits. I think it's a T4, I think they are. There's only two bolts, there's one at the bottom, on top here, there's one just underneath it. So it's two that hold the airflow mass sensor in there. So I'm going to go and get those screws and whack it in. Alright, after you've done the two little T4 bolts in the mass airflow sensor, your airfield should look like this. Now there comes the tricky part, but I've found a trick to do it. You can't really get a tool like screwdriver or anything down in here to undo the ECU. You might be able to undo the top one, but other than that, they're really tight down there. So a little trick, right? I'm gonna need my ECU. I need to get that in position. Now it's in position, it slots in there. Get your little Torx bit again. Put that in. Hand tight, finger tight, whatever you want to call it. Alright, let it dangle there. same size, okay? I think it's a T4, T5. Little didgeridoo, one of these little. It's going to focus. Alright, you're going to need an extension like this. That is it. Okay, so make sure it's a magnetised one so it doesn't drop out. Alright. Alright, so if you've got your magnetised one, you're going to want to get yourself a little spanner. So yeah, so then get the spanner on there, undo and do up Torx bolts. I'll try and get as close as I can. Oh, bloody standard one. Oh, so I'm sorry if it's not coming out as in detail as I can make it and show you, but it's not easy. I just want to get it done as quick as I can as well, but I'll do a quick video just in case someone out there is looking to remove or install their filter again. So as you can see, you can now get that bit in there, get your spanner and do it up. I don't know if you can see. Try the other way. Yeah, I'm sure there's tools out there that can get in here and in a tight space like this and do it up. Alright, so keep doing that. Alright, keep doing that up until it gets quite close to the rubber seal. Don't do it too tightly yet. So after you've done that one up, like I said, don't go too tightly with it yet because you want to make sure it sits nice and flush because you don't want no air leaks. So yeah, you get your next Torx. There's four on each corner of the ECU. There's one up there, there's one down there, there's another one on the side, there's one just underneath, just about under here somewhere. You have to feel for that one underneath here, you have to feel for it. So do your next one up, should be about here. Well, I have a lovely assistant out here helping me with this, holding my camera while I'm doing it. So do it up. It will take its time. I mean, it's quite sharp down there, so you probably will get some scratches on your hands, but never mind. Just keep going at that. Like I said, it's slow, but you will get there. You'll do it up and undo the ECU. So after you've done those bolts up, make sure it just sits nice and flush. Make sure they're done up quite tight. Don't want no air leaks. This is probably the most fiddliest part to do. Trying to take that bit off and we'll get it back on. So trying to get your hand down between a gap like this is not easy, and it's very sharp down there. So yeah, now that's all tightened on there. Just go around, make sure everything's tightened back up. Obviously put your pipe back on, turn up the bolts over there, reconnect all this if you've taken it all apart. And yeah, just check, make sure everything's tight really. I'm gonna get my cover to go back over my ECU. Alright, let's grab your ECU cover. Mine is now coated in the nice gold reflective. Ooh, gold. And it slots just over. Sure it's in there nice and snug. Now get to do your crossover pipe clamp back up. Last thing you need is boost leaks. And every single pipe in this bar can cause a boost leak and lose power. Everything. And they are quite in. On this side, because it's got the stupid bloody pipe that goes around here like that, and if you disconnected the sensor on there, you need to clip it back in. Don't forget to do that. I always do.